Hi, today we are going to talk about the setting and application of NX1000A micro overcurrent earth fault protection relay. So for this application, the incoming is a 11 kV utility going through a DYN11 distribution transformer, which is a 1000 kVA power. Then we have 11 to 400 line to line voltage step down transformer with a percent impedance of 5.75%, X over R ratio of 5.711. Coming through here is the ACB, air circuit breaker, and going through a 1600 stroke 5 current transformer. And this one will be connected to the protection relay, which is the NX1000A. Next, our relay will be setting around 80% normal inverse. So this one will give us 1280 amps. How do you get this? Is 80% of 1600. This is the primary current. So this one is the value where the protection relay will start to pick up. Time multiplying setting will be 0.1. For the high set, we'll be using a definite time with a protection setting of 4 times the setting, which will give us 6004, and this setting is instantaneous. That means there's no intentional time delaying of time. So how do you get 6004? Is 1600 times 4. So this is the tripping pickup current to trip immediately, instantaneous. For the earth fault setting, the low set will be setting IDMT normal inverse 0.1 times. Okay, and this one will give you 160 amps. So it's 1006 times 0.1 will give you this. Time multiplier setting again is 0.1. For the high set, for the earth fault, we will be setting definite time instantaneous, the setting of 20% or 0.2 lah of the 1006. So the current will be tripping, picking up will be 320 amps, which is 0.2 times 1006, which gives you this lah. Okay. So based on the calculation, fault calculation, we will get 21.4 kA three-phase balance fault at the 400 volt busbar and 22.5 kA single line to ground fault. So for the testing, we'll be injecting simulated injecting 2560 amps at simulating at the primary, which is 8 amps at the secondary lah. Okay, which is 2 times of the 80%, 2 times of the setting. Okay, for the high set simulated test, we will be simulating injecting 8000 amps, which is actually only injecting 25 amps at the secondary lah, which is 5 times of 80%. Okay, for the earth fault simulation, we will be injecting 3 times the setting, which is simulating 480 amps on the primary current of the current transformer, which could give us 1.5 amps. What this is what we're injecting lah. So for the high set for the earth fault protection, we'll be injecting 4 times the setting, which is 640 amps simulated, right? Which is 2 amps actually what we've injected. Okay, for the NX1000A, the manual system is shown as such lah. So we will start at zero, position zero, okay? To navigate between the menus, you will need to press the reset button lah, to step within each of them. So it is a circular menu. So every time you reach the end of it at C6, you go back to zero again. So for the first record zero, it is the earth fault current real-time measurement. Then you press reset again, it will show you the real-time measurement of the phase one current, then phase two, phase three. So when you reach T, this number T, this is the last trip elapsed times. Means that let's say the trip happens maybe 20 minutes ago, this will show you 20 m. It will show you 20 minutes. This one will show you up to days, minutes. So the next section, 0, 1, 2, 3 here, this one will have a cursor blinking. Okay, this one means that it is showing you the fault records. So there are 4 fault records for each phase, in each phase of it, and the fault. Okay. these four records, you can store up to 3 times 4 of this individual record. So for example, when L2 have an overcurrent occurring here, so all the L1, L2, L3 will be recorded simultaneously at once. And this will be counted as one record. Next, we have the settings. The settings will start from the low set pickup, then the time multiplier setting or the time delay, depends on whether you're using IDMT at definite time. Then you have the high set pickup, then you have the high set time delay, then you have the Erfurt low set pickup, the low set Erfurt time multiplier setting or time delay, then you have the high set Erfurt pickup and the high set time delay. Next, we come to soft switches. So soft switches, they are C1 to C6. Yes, total of these 6 settings that you have to configure. The soft switch actually determines the functionality of the protection relay. So the soft switch number 1 will determine how the contact 1, the trip contact 1 will be linked to. So you can, like example, if you set to 0-1, the contact R1 will be an auto reset type and linked to overcurrent. If you set to 1-1, it will be manual reset and linked to overcurrent. So it depends on this. For the soft switch number 2, it determines what the trip contact number 2 will be linked to. So again, it is like soft switch number 1. So if you configure to 1-3, it will be the trip contact number 2 will be linked to manual reset and linked to overcurrent effort. That means that when you have a trip, you need to press reset to reset the relay, and this contact will be linked to overcurrent effort. That means when you have an overcurrent or fault event occurring, this switch will turn on. So the soft switch number 3 will determine the high set settings. So you can turn off the high set settings. So you use soft switch number 3 to turn on the fault and overcurrent high set. Turn on and turn off the overcurrent high set. For soft switch number 4, it is selection of the curve. Actually, soft switch. For soft switch number 4 and number 5, it determines what is the curve being used for the overcurrent for the soft switch number 4 and Erfurt for soft switch number 5. And finally, for soft switch number 6, you will determine what is the frequency of the power system network. You can set it to 50 Hz or 60 Hz. So for our application, we are setting the primary pickup current for the phase overcurrent to be 1280 amps. So this one is 80% of 1600 of the CT ratio. Okay. So for our relay, in order to set this, our relay's nominal current is 5 amps. So we need to convert it to 5 amps setting. Meaning that we are setting 0.8. So it's 80% of 5 amps. So you just multiply all the setting by 5 amps. So for here, you get 5 times 0.8, you get 4. For this first setting, we'll be setting in normal inverse with a time multiplier setting of 0.1. So in order to set the relay to be 0.8 times and time multiplier setting of 0.1 with normal inverse, first, we need to use the reset button to scroll it to number 4, which is the low set pickup. So you press until it shows number 4. Okay, so in order to change the setting, we need to press up and down button together simultaneously for one time. Then we will use the up and down button to adjust to the setting of 4. Then to confirm the setting, we will press up and down again. Next, we will need to set it to normal inverse for the overcurrent setting, for the low set. So we are currently at position 5. We will need to reach C4 to access the curve settings. So how do we access it is by pressing the reset to scroll. Now we are at C1, C2, C3, and C4. And C4 is the low set curve setting. And for 0, 0, it is normal inverse 3/10 curve. So for the next setting, it is the high set for the overcurrent. Okay, we already decided we want to set to definite time at 4 times the setting. Okay, so which is gives us the primary current, which is 6400 amps. And to convert it to the relay's nominal setting, we need to multiply this number 4 by multiplying number with 5. So the setting will be 20 in on the relay. And the time delay that we want will be instantaneous. The 50 milliseconds is the fastest the relay can operate. So for us to access to the high set of the relay, which is position number 6, we again press reset. Up to number 6. And we will press up and down again to change the setting. And now we need to set it to 20. And up down again to confirm the settings. Next, we will need to set the time delay to the fastest tripping time of the relay, which is at position 7. So again, we press the reset button to access to position 7, and it is already showing that it is 50 milliseconds or 0.05. For the high set, this relay only has definite time setting. For the Erfurt low set setting, we are setting it to be normal inverse IDMT 0.1 times, which is 160 amps at the primary, time multiply setting of 0.1. So in order to convert it into relay setting, we need to multiply the 0.1 by 5, which is 0.5. Next, we will set the Erfurt low set pickup value, which is number 8. So we are at position 7 now. We press reset and we reach to number 8. And our setting is 0.5, so we don't have to change anything. And the time delay is accessed at number 9, so press reset again. So, and the time delay is 0.1 time multiply setting. Again, we don't have to change anything. Okay. Now we need to make sure that the Erfurt curve for the low set is normal inverse. So it is located at soft switch number 5, C5. So we'll press the reset again to scroll to number 5, and it's 0, 0 here, and it is normal inverse curve 3/10, and we don't have to change anything. The last setting we have is the high set for the Erfurt, which is definite time at 0.2, which is the setting. So it is 320 amps at the primary current. If it detects this, it will start to pick up and trip instantaneously. And we will need to set this to 1.0, which is again, our relay's nominal is 5. So you need to multiply the setting here by 5, which is, will give you 1.0. Now we want to set the Erfurt high set, which is located at number A. So we are position 7 now, so we press reset, 8, 9, A. And now we need to set it to 1.0. So we press up down, and press down, and hold. And up down again to confirm the setting. Next, we will set the time delay for the high set. So we will access it at number B. So you press reset, and it is already 0.05, which is the fastest trip time available for this relay. For the first injection, we will inject 2 times of the setting, which we will inject 8 amps, simulating 2560 amps. We will be setting the normal inverse curve 310. What do you mean by 310? 310 means that the relay, when setting by normal inverse curve, with a time multiplier setting of 1, at 10 times the setting current, it will trip at 3 seconds, which is here. So 10, 1, 2, 3, and it's here. You can see. So for our example, we will be setting normal inverse and time with a time multiplier setting of 0.1 at 2 times the setting current. This will give a trip time of 1 second. Now we will inject 2 times the relay setting, which is 8 amps, into the relay. The relay trips, and it is indicated that low set has tripped, and the tripping value is 7.98 amps registered by the relay at phase L1. As you can see from the current injector, the trip time is 1.0221 seconds. After the relay has tripped, you can reset the relay by pressing reset. And you can see the trip contact, you can hear the trip contact and switch over. After reset, we can see the trip records and the tripping time from the relay by pressing the reset. Over here, it shows that the relay has trips within 2 minutes. And by pressing the next reset, we will show the earth fault trip record, the latest earth fault trip record. And by pressing again, we can see the phase 1 latest trip record, which is showing that 7.98 amps. And again, for L2 is 0 amps and L3 is 0 amps, as we only inject the fault current in L1. For the high set injection, we'll be injecting 5 times of the 80% setting, which is 25 amps on the secondary and 8000 amps simulated on the primary. So we'll inject now. As you can see, the relay has tripped at a high set and the trip current is 25 amps at phase 1. Now we will start to simulate the earth fault tripping. So for the low set, we are using IDMD normal inverse and the tripping level is 160 amps. For the high set, it's definite time instantaneous and the tripping amps is 320 amps. We will purposely inject 480 amps, which convert to secondary is 1.5 amps. As you can see, the high set and low set both will pick up, but the high set will trip first because it is faster than the low set setting. And the 480 amps simulated injected to the relay, it is higher than both the low set 160 and the high set 320. So this concludes our tutorial and our demonstration and simulation for our Micros Overcurrent and Earth Fault Relay NX1000A series.